This podcast is part of the Deluxe Edition Network. To find other great shows on the network, head over to deluxeeditionnetwork.com. That's deluxeeditionnetwork.com.
Elliot Richards needs a life.
You're the man, Elliot.
It's all about first impression. Go over there, say hello.
But most of all, he wants Allison.
Hi.
Hi. Do I know you?
Oh, I sure hope so. We've only been working together for the last 4 years.
I don't think I've ever seen you before.
You know, I'm here with some friends, and I was wondering if maybe you wanted to...
Elliot has never had any of his dreams come true.
I would give anything to have that girl in my life.
Until now.
Hello. You're very glib. I bet you're a whiz with the ladies.
Well.
Let's go someplace quiet so we can talk.
Okay.
What if I told you that I have the power to give you anything and everything you've always dreamed of?
Who are you?
Promise not to tell anyone? I'm the devil.
Yeah, right.
I am the devil. Satan, Lucifer, the Prince of Darkness. Well, the Princess of Darkness, anyway.
Why don't we take a look at the contract?
I, the devil, with offices in Purgatory Hell in Los Angeles, will give you 7 wishes for one piddling little soul.
Is this real?
It could be. Sign it, Elliot.
Okay. I wish that I were married to Allison and that I were very, very rich and very powerful.
You got it.
Muy buenos días, señor. ¿Le apetece algo de comer?
Como dices, no habla español.
Un momento. Realmente estoy hablando español.
Hola. Mucho gusto.
No, gracias. Soy alérgico a los crustáceos.
Elliot may have 7 wishes.
You turned me into a drug dealer.
What's the big deal?
You asked for rich and powerful.
But she's not going to give him...
Back so soon?
...a chance in hell. Bedazzled.
Nobody gets it totally right away. That's why you get 7 wishes.
Besides, do I look like somebody who'd try to trick you?
Hey nerds, it's Sammy, and this is Barrel Age Chicks. Let's do this. Tonight on panel we have...
This is Snow, and I'm fine!
And finally...
Hey everybody, this is Yin. Time to turn your head and cough, because I'm about to check your facts.
To another episode of Barrel Age Chicks.
Yay!
All right.
The devil's in the house.
Ow, wait. Ow. That's a wolf. No, that's a wolf.
We got that.
No.
Boom.
There's wolves.
That's not werewolves.
They're hellhounds.
Oh, right. Yeah.
That's right. Our hellhounds.
That.
What are we doing today, Yen? Niffer?
Well, because I am falling in line with a little character trifecta.
Brendan Fraser trifecta.
Yay. I love me some Brendan Fraser. I have also chosen, or I have chosen, Bedazzled as one of his...
Such a fun movie.
Movies. What?
I don't know.
You no, it was it. The picture of Ron sucking on the dick. So oh. I was trying to get your attention.
You put it in your slideshow, so that's on you.
Wow.
Sorry.
He wants to be remembered of that moment.
So you picked Bedazzled.
I picked Bedazzled, and some would feel like it's probably not one of his most or his best
movies.
Jobs as an actor. Yeah. Yeah. But
it's a fun movie. I like it.
I really just found a lot of fun in it. I mean, it was a fun movie, a lighthearted, fun movie. So just give you a little bit of a snapshot of the movie and then we'll charge into this, devilish drink. Sorry. So this movie was released back in October 20th of 2000. It is considered a romantic fantasy comedy. Director Harold Ramis. Its initial budget was $48 million. In box office, it made $90.3 million. PG-13. Cast includes Brendan Fraser as Elliot Richards, Elizabeth Hurley as the Devil, Frances O'Connor as Allison, but also Nicole Delarusso.
Yeah.
Kind of makes two little thing there.
Nikki, Nick, me,
and just me, Nick. She's such a. We'll get into that later. No worries. We will get there. Also shows Orlando Jones, Paul Edelstein, and Toby Huss as some of the characters that you'll see in each version of his wish. They all kind of make a little appearance. Which is kind of
They weren't his friend group, but they were his social peers.
Yeah,
his work work peers.
They
were
his peers, so they ended up in all of his little dreams, adventures. Yeah,
wishes.
Yeah.
So this is a remake again of a movie that was made back in 1967 with the script written by Peter Cook and Dudley Moore, and in this one, both of them, it's a down on the luck kind of nerdish guy, doesn't have a lot of friends, but falls in line with the devil who will grant him 7 wishes for his soul, and Elliot is trying to win over this girl's love that he works with. He just finds her extremely attractive.
He's got a crush.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a very learning of oneself kind of movie.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's another word. I can't think of the word for it. But anyway.
That works. Well, because his crush on her is super superficial because he knows nothing about her.
Oh, yeah.
It's
yeah.
just a but completely wants, superficial yeah. crush, but he can't shake it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, because the devil plays a big role in this movie. Mm-hmm. And Elliot and the devil are pretty much the lead roles of this the film. The drink that I have in front of you is called the Red Devil.
Mm-hmm.
And let me pull up.
It looks like grapefruit juice.
Mine does. Mine definitely does.
So my husband tested
yours
this
looks
out.
Like unsugared grapefruit juice, and this looks like the sugary grapefruit juice.
Yeah. The real grapefruit
juice. Yeah, like that was like the real. And we've got the maraschino cherry version or something. So what is in the one that Snow and I are having is 1.5 ounces of vodka. I chose lemon vodka because ingredients have a citrusy key to it. 1.5 ounces of peach schnapps, 1.5 ounces of Southern Comfort, 1.5 ounces of gin, 2 ounces of triple sec, and 2 ounces of orange juice.
And a partridge in a pear tree.
And
that is a lot.
Grenadine.
Woof.
I don't think I had a grenadine in yours. However, you can add it if you'd like to.
No,
so the mocktail version, and Sammy's version is 2 ounces of pomegranate juice, 1 ounce of freshly squeezed orange juice or high quality orange juice, which we used simply orange.
Ooh, yum.
1/2 ounces lime juice, 2 ounces of sparkling. I think I used club soda. And then ice.
Ooh.
I added a little bit extra orange juice, pomegranate juice, and a little bit more sparkling water only because it didn't quite make as many. Because our Snow and I's drink is like
gigantic,
10 to 12 ounces of stuff. And then yours ended up being more like 8. So I added extra. So, and it garnished with orange wedge, or you can garnish with cherries. Whatever you want to do to make it fun.
Yum yum.
So yeah, my husband tried it. It's apparently a lot of flavors.
Interesting. So,
yeah.
All right. Cheers.
You all ready?
Clinky clinky. Oh shit!
I cheers to your orange.
No.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
She got aggressive.
Why am I smelling the microphone?
I wouldn't smell Stu's mic.
I smelled the wrong thing.
Dude, for as much alcohol as in that, you really can't taste a lot of alcohol.
Yeah.
Whoa.
It tastes like juice. It tastes like a very, like a minorly spiked juice. And I know there's a ton of alcohol in here. Mm. So this could be very dangerous because that's pretty delicious.
I wonder if it's another thing where it led, like, sunk to the bottom.
Maybe. Oh, we might need to mixy.
Yeah. Oh.
I don't have a...
What's up over there? Oh.
Ooh, oh, no. That's tart.
You need...
No, it's just not good.
What do you need? Grenadine? Oh. Is it the club soda?
It maybe?
Club soda's so nasty.
It's...
I mean, if you want, I can make you a version with the Sprite in it instead. I was really going for
it's
not similarity, but color.
So it is tart. Mm-hmm. It's like I'm getting all of the tart notes of every fruit. So like the pomegranate, the tartness, the lime juice, the tartness, the orange juice, even the tartness there. And it's a lot of acid.
Hmm.
And it's just, it tastes like a lot of acid.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have anything sweet to break it. Mm-hmm. So it's just
tart,
super tart and not in a good way.
Mm-hmm. That's unfortunate. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. So I'm going to have to go with like a half middle finger.
That's fine.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah. It's no good.
I don't even know what this darn drink was called.
Pomegranate
mocktail.
Yeah, I think if you brought in a sweet note,
yeah,
even if like you put like a little simple syrup in it, I think that something to cut that tart, because yeah, right now it just feels like you're drinking just like very acidic fruit juice.
Okay,
but I appreciate the effort, and I'm gonna eat my orange.
Get a half a middle finger for effort. I'm gonna give you two middle fingers because I think this is really really tasty. I do think this is like a sipping one. Because I can already feel the warmth hitting from all of the alcohols that are in here. But it has a really nice tropical flavor. I really enjoy this.
Yeah.
You did a good job.
Thank you. I was a little concerned about how much alcohol was going into it. I was hoping it wasn't going to turn into a,
It's like a fruity Long Island. It's like a fruity Long Island.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. So instead of cutting it with Coke, you're cutting it with the pomegranate juice.
Yeah. Well, I didn't put pomegranate juice in this.
Oh,
one.
Not in this
it's
one.
It's just grenadine and orange juice that makes this color.
Well, the orange juice then, yeah.
And then, so you have the citrusy flavors from the vodka that's got lemon, the Southern Comfort.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure how the peach was going to fall into that because I didn't feel like that was a very citrusy flavor, but I mean.
Peach is weird. Peach schnapps is weird. Peach schnapps almost, it adds like a kicker. It brings out different notes of fruity,
yeah,
depending on what you pair it with.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a weird thing. I remember that back when I did drink, when I would play.
Yeah.
I can't tell you exactly why, but it is something about peach schnapps.
The orange is good dipped in it. The garnish?
The oranges are just good. I snacked on that.
Yeah.
Jump that in there. Well, some more orange around the bar if you'd like another orange slice.
Mm. Yeah.
Or if you want to just throw some sugar in that. No, let's not worry about it.
Yeah. That's good. I like it.
Well, what about you, Yen? What would your review be?
I would give it two.
Yeah.
I mean, I could definitely see myself drinking this, game night or whatever.
I was going to say, you could probably make like a big batch of it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This might be a good pitcher drink.
Yeah. There you go.
Well, see, this version I did, with the version that I made here, I did add more juice.
Mm-hmm.
Because my husband's reaction of how strong it was initially. So I was like, well, let me just add a little extra juice.
Yeah.
No, it's really good.
Yay.
Good job.
Thanks. Hey, listeners, let me tell you about a friend of ours from Coffee Bros. They source seasonal award-winning and specialty coffees focusing on high-scoring and high-quality blends, espresso roasts, and single-origin coffees.
Experience complex taste notes from fragrant and aromatic to bold and rich. It's yummy.
Coffee Bros are a two-person brother team, hence the name. They roast all their coffee in small batches out of their New York City roastery.
Start your day the awesome way with Coffee Bros coffee. Not to mention, if you drop the BAC10 code, you will save 10% on your purchases. Enjoy Coffee Bros!
So in the beginning of this movie, we meet Elliot, the main character. And he is a computer nerd through and through. Got the glasses with the bar on the top. My dad used to wear glasses like that, and it was kind of funny. It's like, oh, that's fun. And he tries to make friends with his coworkers, but you can tell his coworkers are just
irritated.
Try to stay away from him. Avoid him.
I think he thinks he's friends with them. He's so socially awkward.
Mm-hmm.
He thinks. They're his friends, and they're people who just make fun of him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And definitely
jerks.
Yeah. Any interaction is a good interaction, even though in the back of his mind and in his heart, he knows it's not good, but he's like, take anything he can get, any scrap he can get.
Yeah.
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 He's just so lonely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So when he thinks he's going to the bar by himself after asking his friends if they were going, and they turned him down.
No.
And then he goes to the bar and sees all his friends there. He sees Allison, who is our next major character in the show, His love interest, and you can tell, like, the music changes. And I love her. And then he makes something like saying, I would do anything.
I would give anything to be in a relationship with her.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And so that triggers, cue the devil.
Yeah.
How would you like to make one simple decision that'll change your life forever?
Simple decision.
Okay, I'm glad Scientology works for you, but...
Just listen. What if I told you that I have the cataclysmic power to give you anything and everything you've always dreamed of?
She was perfect.
She did so good. And she's beautiful.
Oh, stunning.
Okay.
Cross your heart and hope to die.
So optimistic. Please, hope to die.
Yeah.
I'm the devil.
Okay. I think somebody's had tea many martinis.
I am the devil. Satan, Lucifer, Beelzebub, the Prince of Darkness. Well, the Princess of Darkness, anyway. Here's my card.
I do love that he's like, oh, now it's official. You are the devil.
Okay.
Just one word. Just very nice. Very neat. Very neat card.
So after he goes back to this like club zone where it's like, oh, he's super popular. Everybody knows his name. Mm-hmm. She takes him to her office, signs this big old contract after he sees what he could possibly have with Allison. Like, oh, man, it's beautiful. You know, she loves me. I love her.
Fabio hair. Yes.
The costume and makeup that they put him in each iteration is really hilarious.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
So it's like the big fucking nose when he's the Colombian drug lord. The
freckles.
The blonde, like tight afro.
When he's the basketball player.
The albino fucking look. When he's 8 feet fucking tall. All of it. It's just really, so really good. Funny. And then they make the suave and debonair.
Yep.
Gay. It's all really, really funny. Yeah.
Yeah. So I pulled clips for all the different versions, but we'll start with the very first wish that he has to make after.
Rich and powerful and married to Allison.
Yeah. So first he, she tries to say, well, really, I am the devil. Ask me anything. And he's like, well, like a Big Mac and Coke.
Yeah.
And like literally she drives him to McDonald's.
Takes the bus.
He has to pay. I mean, all of this stuff is like, how
this
is that
truly
even?
Is the work of the devil.
McDonald's is probably the work of the devil. So after officially like, okay, fine. You know what? This is what I want.
All
right. Right. I wish that I were married to Allison and that I were very, very rich and very powerful. How's that sound?
Sounds good to me. Enjoy.
I love this music so much.
So the only reason I didn't like tag in a clip of
him speaking Spanish.
Hola Juan, hola Esteban, ¿dónde es la biblioteca? Este caso de mi tía.
I don't know if it would fall as funny without being able to read the subtitles and know exactly what he's saying.
So
audio wise, it would have probably made as much of a funny.
It's more his inflection when he's saying the words, than it is because he's so like shocked and overjoyed in being able to speak fluent Spanish. That's where the funny part is.
His butler's is like, are you okay?
You've been hitting your own cocaine.
It's as good as when he's like, all of a sudden he can speak Russian.
Yes. Of course I can speak Russian. Yes.
So great.
I think that was probably, I know it was the first, but I think that was probably my favorite rendition of his wish. Because it was just right off the bat, hilarious.
Yeah.
I don't speak Spanish. Wait a minute. Oh, yes, I do. my Spanish teacher would be so happy.
Well, you have that nerdy innocence and the situation of him being this high power drug cartel Colombian drug lord.
Yes.
And he's like, why are we getting upset about sugar or flour? Yeah.
Like, of course, I'm a cocaine? Yeah. Cocaine?
It's cocaine.
Oh my gosh.
Cocaine?
It's so cocaine. Of course, I'm a cocaine.
And he's just he's just horrified when he realizes, like, oh, this is how the devil made it happen.
I'm getting out of the business.
Oh my gosh.
And you have Allison Raul.
Oh my gosh.
She was such a whore.
She spoke really good Spanish.
She did
really, really, really fluent.
Muchas cosas nuevas.
So much hate in there. Oh,
dude.
Yeah.
Something she did was... when that flip switched.
Oh, yeah. I despise.
Like, dude.
It sounds like I despise you, but I'm sure it was from Spanish.
Dude, it was so good. I mean,
you could tell she had a lot of fun
with all the different
variations. Of her characters.
Yeah. I mean,
you know, because that was the fun thing is each person had so many different characters to play. Even the little side character, the buddies. Yep. They all had so much fun, like kicking sand in Brendan Fraser's face over and over and over again, being a dick. Like, there's just a lot of fun there.
No, and I mean, and it's I think kind of cool when you think about how you have the same group of five people or so, but you have such different storylines in each of these different wishes.
Yeah, they get unbeknownst to them, they're dragged into his wishes.
Yeah.
Like, one of them becomes his gay lover. And, like, they got no choice.
And I'm
like,
Tony Danza.
Like, you're not only signing the contract for yourself, you're signing it for all the people around you who are being dragged into this shit. They didn't sign the contract, but they're being dragged right into it, which I think is kind of funny.
That is.
Yeah.
I didn't think of it that way. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So, first wish, he ends up being a Colombian drug lord.
Yeah. Yes.
That does not bone out well.
No. Right?
And because the Russians' drug deal goes bad.
Yep.
Well,
yep.
And then Raul takes over the business.
Yeah. Yes, because Raul is a jerk.
I just thought it was so funny. Like, it had all of the action-y...
tropes.
Yes, because he's running away from the building. He has explosions in the background. He grabs onto the helicopter's leg and holds and hangs by it.
Yes.
The devil ended up giving him his little pager, dial 666 to get out of whatever, you know,
come right back to me.
So
if it doesn't work out, what do you mean if it doesn't work out? Just in case.
All right. So clearly the first wish for him did not work out very well. His wife hated him, wanted to see him dead.
Yes, she did.
Wanted to marry someone, or wanted to be with someone else, cheated on him. He was a drug lord running away, trying not to be killed. Falls from the helicopter, pushes his little pager 666.
Six.
And then falls directly onto the top of a car.
Dude, he took that hard.
I'm sure he did his own stunt. No, I don't know about that.
He did that, sucker.
I doubt he did. Yes.
But I love the sound he made as he hit it. He's like, oof.
Yes.
Well, I love that her parking cop outfit was like from it was from like, what's a Spirit Halloween?
Yeah. She looked like a stripper.
She was a sexy police officer.
Yeah.
Like the hot boots and the mini skirt. And I'm like,
so
really?
Funny.
You really went shopping at Halloween.com to get your fucking police uniform.
I mean, it was in October 20th, so they were full-on Halloween costumes.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
That is funny. But yes, as she walks and she keeps snapping and dinging everybody and giving them parking tickets.
Yeah, she's like, oh, that's expired.
Speaking of parking tickets.
Yeah, and then she changes all the lights to green so everybody just hits each other. And he's like, you can't do that. She's like, devil.
Yeah, she's like, I'm not with her.
I don't know where this is going. So then they jump over because... He realizes then maybe he needs to
be more specific.
See what she wants in a man.
Well, she recommends it. She's like, you're approaching this the wrong way. Why don't we go and spy on her and find out what it is she's actually looking for?
Yeah. So they jump over to her room. She can't see them, but he's like,
yes.
And she's reading, the devil's reading the journal while all that's happening. And then we go into the second wish.
Which are the most emotionally sensitive men? In the world.
Damn, I was hoping you wouldn't catch that.
I could have had a lot of fun with that one.
Physically and emotional.
Love me.
Would you mind if I sketched you?
I didn't know you could draw.
I'm not an artist, per se.
Okay, Elliot, there's something that I think I really have to say. Elliot, that's amazing!
Compared to you, it's nothing. Compared to your smile and the blush of your cheek and the sound of your voice as it floats on the evening breeze, compared to you, that sunset's just...
See, this one I would have believed was gay.
Yeah, right?
Like, if you were to make one of them gay, this one...
Tuna niçoise.
Yeah.
I just love how every time he looks at that sunset, he immediately starts crying.
When's it gonna set?
When it's tempting to set.
Yeah.
But, with the red hair and all the freckles.
Yes. The green eyes.
So. And he had the weirdest teeth.
He did.
Like, they put these it looked like they put these dentures in him for everything, and they just got weirder and weirder every time.
I did love how, yeah, like you said earlier.
There was, like, subtle things to the makeup that was, like...
The nose shape the smile, the teeth.
They really made it an individual character each time.
But you could always see Elliot.
I'm not going to lie, though. Real quick, going back to the first wish. Yeah. Like, the first time I saw it, I was like,
hey,
Brendan. Latino Brendan. I'm kind of like, all right, I'm here for you.
He had a nose that was this big.
I don't care.
That's okay.
It worked.
the greasy, oily Latin
hair.
I'm half Mexican. What do you want?
Walking out with just pants on and a robe. I mean, that's how I picture all my Spanish
lovers.
Yes. In their mansion made of cocaine.
Mm-hmm. All from the cocaine.
That's why it was white.
Yeah.
Misestablos.
That's what the walls were made out of.
Misestablos. But sorry, I had to bring that up. But I agreed. Like, you have all of these very
strong,
subtle. Very subtle tweaks, and it does make the characters that much more.
It doth make
funny.
Them
funny.
Yes. Oh wait. So after that one, when the sensitive one fails, because clearly, like, this is not the sensitive that she was looking for.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. So I want to bring this up. What do you think that wasn't really her diary? That the devil just made that shit up.
100%.
Yeah, I didn't think about that.
Yeah, I think that was, like, not her real diary.
She's like,
the five guys that I just had a train ran on me just left. And da-da-da-da-da.
Yes.
Like, I totally think that the whole diary was fake.
That's funny.
No,
she was like, just to fuck with him.
I think so. I think just to get him to make him wishes.
From the get-go, she's like, 3 weeks in, she's like, I really can't stand you. And it's getting worse by the minute.
Oh my gosh.
Dude, but her whole thing, she's like, I just want somebody who's going to ignore me.
Take me
for granted.
And do nothing but want to get my pants off. He's like, I'm the guy.
I can do that.
Yeah, I got you.
I got a van.
He's like, okay.
My place,
like, we can go to your place.
40 minutes,
like,
perfect.
It's 40 minutes away. Oh, all right. You got a car? No, I got a van. We're going to do it in the van right now with my buddies watching. Okay.
Oh my gosh.
Stupid. But she hit the way that her inflection was on it.
Yes.
It's great.
Well, what's funny, though, is, like, when you see her do that flip to where, like, no, I'll go with you, stranger, right now to go get fucked. Then you're like, well, maybe the train thing was the real. And then the sensitive thing was made up by the devil.
Oh, my gosh.
Allison is a choo-choo.
She's a horse. Mm. Oh, my goodness. Mm. At least that version of her was. Yeah. Actually, the first two versions of Allison are pretty whorish.
Yeah, so it makes you wonder what she's really like as a real person. The real Allison.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Is
the
his
devil,
crush on her was
the
so
devil
superficial.
Has more insight to that than Elliot does.
Yeah,
true. So then it shoots to the her teaching... The classroom,
the sexy
devil.
School teacher.
Yeah, so which was actually her outfit. That she owns that outfit.
Oh,
yes. So
right.
I remember her name. What was her name?
Liz Hurley.
Elizabeth Hurley.
Yeah. So that was her personal wardrobe.
She brought that out of her closet.
Sure did.
Yeah.
Jeez, dang on.
Get it, girl.
That's funny.
Yeah.
Shake it.
She got a happy husband or boyfriend or whatever.
Yes, she does.
Yes, she does.
She's super pretty.
Oh, just to let you know, like, there were 19 different outfits
that for her,
for just her,
Elizabeth Hurley had changed into.
She had so many. I definitely like what would be your favorite?
Oh. Ooh.
The angel one with the floating halo was cute.
Didn't she have a red jumpsuit type of deal, skin tight?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'd like that.
That was the one that she was on the Lamborghini Diablo.
If I was skinny
with like the cognac,
like that body shape, I would definitely.
Dude, that
I like her red dress with the slit up to her peach and the black heels that were like Louboutins.
Oh,
those things were awesome when she took him into her office the first time.
Yeah,
that was fun.
Oh,
that
was
good.
Yeah.
You know what?
Schoolgirl, isn't it? Is the school
girl? No, no. It's gonna be
the
one
sexy
where...
police officer.
No, it's actually the one with the fuzzy boots. The with the red fuzzy boots.
The big puffy red jacket.
The big puffy jacket and her like cute little hairs up and her sunglasses. Yeah. Like, her club look.
Yeah.
I liked her club look.
She's so funny. Oh my gosh.
But what killed me were those damn fuzzy boots.
Well, what's funny is like, okay, you got these seven wishes and you have to take them back to back to back to back. Like, you don't get any time between.
Yeah.
Like, you have to immediately adjust your wish.
Well, I think she was really, really rushing.
She just wanted
him.
His soul.
She didn't want him to think about it too much because then he might start getting really detailed.
Well, which is what happened is he ended up, he's like, you know what? I'm out. And she's like,
oh. Slightly disturbing that your fake ear peaks are on the mat right now.
Why? They're cute.
I know, but it's like you're sticking them into it.
I know. They're standing on their own.
Sorry. little ear mountain peaks.
So my son dressed me this morning, my 5-year-old son, and he grabbed my earring. He's like, you know, you need earrings. I'm like, I don't want to wear earrings today. He was like, okay. So he grabbed the biggest fucking hoop earring. and then he was like, oh, you have elf ears. I want to put on elf ears. And you're going to put on elf ears. I'm like, okay. So whatever.
So they just
and
then sit I want on you to, top of your ear.
Yeah.
There's no like.
No, it's no
adhesive or anything that goes.
No, they just
it.
Kind of cuff.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
I gotcha.
They look like Vulcan ears, which is kind of funny.
Yeah.
They are. They're really fun. And then he's like, oh, and then you need a barrette, and he's going into my shit, and he's like, I'm like, I'm not wearing a barrette. I'm not wearing makeup. I'm like, you need to just stop. You need to leave. I'm tired. Hungover. I really need you to just. I'll wear the
we
ears.
We lost an hour last
and
night.
And I'll wear the earrings.
Oh, dude,
and it was
I'm
late.
Feeling that hour, man. I'm
it was a
you.
Late night, and I got punished a lot on the guy's show.
Oh yeah,
I got
yeah,
punished a lot
yeah,
on the
did.
Guy's show.
What happened?
It was just, like five punishment shots.
There was a lot
in, like,
of spicy boners.
Minutes.
There was a lot of spicy boners.
You said
boners.
Names.
I said. Did I say names?
It was a couple. Somebody else said. I did.
You did.
Ron did.
I think I said a name.
We got
somebody
voted
else
down.
Said my. He said my name,
but we got voted down.
There was self destructs. There
two.
Was
two self destructs.
Yeah,
it was.
Oh, it was a lot. But I was definitely the culprit of things because I like to instigate. You wouldn't know it, but I'm really bad instigator of trouble.
What? You
no. Yeah, you would
what?
Never realize that if you
no.
met me that I like to
never.
Cause trouble. And even if it's self-sabotaging.
Holy cow.
All right.
Yeah.
So we had sensitive Elliot.
Sensitive Elliot.
And did not
needs to be shot behind a barn.
Well. Yeah. Put him out of his misery. He was so annoying.
So
whiny.
Moving on to the next wish.
So then he was like, I wanna be
everything that she said she wanted, which was
a
just an abusive
player.
Asshole.
Yes. Yeah. Which brings us to...
What we got. What happened during that wish?
God, it's so exciting to be here. I mean, you must have an enormously huge talent to do what you do.
Talent.
Well, you know, you go out there and you just give 110%.
And so dumb.
You hope you play
the
good.
The sweating.
And you want to play
tea.
Good.
Yeah,
his teeth.
He's pretty good tonight.
But like just the pouring
God,
wet
incredible.
Sweat. Yes. Oh, not to mention he's wearing like a dish towel around his waist. Which it should have been a clue to the tiny peen that nothing was hanging out of the dish towel.
Well, it gets a little bit bigger.
And again, Allison is a whore.
So that's three versions she's a whore.
Three versions.
But she's trying to get into his pants.
Wanna go back to my place? I'll show you my bottle cap collection.
Oh, my God. That would be tremendous.
Yeah, tremendous.
Right, well,
God.
I also should, large. Should get dressed.
Should you now?
I can't wait.
Even there.
He's like, oh. You know. Bow down. Come on.
Take it off. Oh my God.
Oh! Hey! I am the devil! I am the devil too! Hell!
God, there's just
this
teeny tiny thing I gotta go do. I just it's very small, itty bitty.
Oh,
God, I remembered there's just this teeny tiny thing.
Teeny what's tiny? Teeny?
What's teeny? No, that's something that I have to write.
You, about me?
It's about you. It's really small.
But itty bitty blurb. Well, can I see you after the road trip?
God, you know, I would love to, but I'm working on a really big, huge, enormous story on the NFL, so I probably won't have time.
Yeah. Somebody else's big dick.
I understand.
Yep.
You gotta get 110%.
110%. Right.
Stay within yourself.
Hey. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks for your time.
So long.
Damn the devil to hell.
Oh, shoot. Where the heck did I put that?
So that and then he tries to do the numbers and he can't get it. Oh, God.
Yeah.
That was, when he's on the interview and the water's pouring.
The water's it's got to be like a hose in his hair.
Yes. Yeah.
That's just dumping the water and he's spitting all over the guy.
I saw the behind the scenes films of that. And I'm sure it looked like they had done several takes because it almost seemed like some of the stuff that he was saying was kind of ad-libbing.
Yeah.
To the interview's conversation.
Well, think of how distracting. Like, even if you have the script memorized, how distracting would it be to just have water pouring off of your face?
And he ended up losing his contact and all of that, which is not surprising.
Yeah.
I didn't know he needed contacts, but I guess, But, that was funny.
So stupid.
The little talent was wasted. Not show
nothing.
Anything worth hiding.
Dude, and he just full on just like open trouser too.
Yeah.
Like he doesn't even like try to sign it. He's just like, all right.
He's she's obviously there looking
for that. And once he finally realized that's what she wanted to see, he was like, okay, I'll show you. Oh no, where's my flash?
Yeah. I think one of the things I was kind of interested in was the fact that through all of these wishes, he seems to be a little bit more daring, a little bold. More than what he had been as his computer geek. Now, is that part of his wish and he gets a little more confident with that?
I think that's his growing. As he's going through these different experiences, he as a person is starting to get a little bit more backbone. He's starting to discover what I do and don't want.
Yeah.
And so it's actually like a learning experience in himself as he goes.
Yeah.
So that's why like by the end of the movie, he's
had
completely
all of this
different than what he is at the beginning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And selling his soul to the devil is like the best thing that could ever happen to him because he just becomes, you know, the person that he, you know, was meant to be. And he ends up finding somebody who's exactly fucking like him.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I mean, like even in the first one, the Colombian drug lord, I mean, he does things like, if it was just Elliot, the computer nerd starting off, would he actually ever approach his wife to say, hey, are you cheating on me with this guy over here?
Yeah.
I don't think he would have been bold enough to have that confrontation.
Well, he also was like, denial. No, she's just learning English. Like, for sure. Like, he had a lot of denial in that, too.
But when he busted into their bedroom and confronted her about this, I really don't think that the original Elliot would have even approached that.
I don't know, because I think he would have been pissed off that he had basically gotten this wish, like, and she's supposed to be married to him. Like, he was like, this is what I'm supposed to get. And then she doesn't love him. She's cheating on him. Mm-hmm. I think that he got genuinely just pissed.
I think that the anger was also not at her. It was at the devil.
That's what I'm saying.
So, he got cheated.
Because
Allison had nothing to do with his wishes. His wishes were super self-fulfilling.
Yeah.
They didn't have anything to do with her until the very last one where his crush, she's like, no, I just want her to have a good life. And that was the self-sacrificing thing. But again, even in that instance, he's just wishing well for somebody that he doesn't fucking know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, which is, I think, where the more self-sacrifice comes in. Cause it's not like I want my family to be happy and healthy for the rest of their lives.
Yeah.
Like that's self-serving a little bit because it's your family. This is a stranger that he's wishing to have a good life.
Which is It's a sacrificial, it's selfless love.
Yes.
And that is the polar opposite of Satan, which is why it's the deal breaker. Mm-hmm.
One thing I thought that was kind of funny is in the original scene, or original, shoot, not the original, that's not the word I want. In the initial scene where he is sitting at his cubicle at work, there is a sticker off to the right of him that says the Diablos.
Yes. Yeah.
And he's apparently a basketball fan anyways.
Mm-hmm.
And then he ends up being a player of the Diablos.
Yeah.
Well, even when he's trying, he wants to go and meet up and play basketball with the guys.
Yeah. He wanted to be a basketball player.
Yeah. And they don't want to.
I mean, he's 6'3". I can't blame him.
He's like, when I showed up at the gym, you guys were leaving. You told me the wrong time. How stupid do you feel? Yeah. And they're like, oh yeah, really, really stupid, Elliot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And apparently I didn't see it until, cause I looked up some of the facts after I watched the video. So if you guys happen to go watch it again after all of this, apparently the name of the other team was Shirts.
That's funny.
Cause you know, it's like Shirts and Skins.
Yeah.
That's funny.
So
that's funny.
I didn't even look at it, but I thought that would have been, super funny. All right. So then
I have a feeling that a silly movie like this is going to have a lot of little hidden things like that you're just never going to notice unless you know to look for them.
Yeah.
So just as an inside joke to the people who made the film.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Which are some of the best.
Yes.
Definitely.
And yeah. I can't imagine the amount of fun that people had filming this movie.
I
think it was just.
It's hilarious. When you're doing characters that are so out of whack with what is a norm, it's very freeing in and of itself because you get to be a total jackass.
Yeah.
And it's completely acceptable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. And encouraged, even, which is what makes it great.
The more outrageous, the better.
Yeah.
Insert any Adam Sandler movie.
So then for his next wish, after being completely defeated by the whole tiny penis situation, he was like, I want to be rich, articulate, popular.
With a big dick.
Yep.
With a big dick.
He had to adjust himself.
I want a big. He's like, what do you want? It's like, you know, I want to be, I want to be good.
Comically big.
Yeah. I want to be like arm rest. Yeah. Elephant tusk. Or elephant.
Not like, not trunk, like what is trunk, that black guy meme with the naked black guy meme on the couch.
Yeah. So this is what we get.
Oh, there it goes. Sorry.
That's fine.
Oh, this is so perfect. Everything here
again.
Absolutely,
she's already ready to bang him.
Yeah,
number four.
Which, again, I really think that diary entry of her having the train run on her was real.
In the bedroom.
Love the music behind this. So romantic. Here he comes.
What the hell is going on, Mary?
Mary,
who are you?
Don't play games with me, Mr. Richards. I'm in no mood. Richards. I've been out of my mind all night.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Hi.
Hi.
Who's your little friend?
Maybe I should be running along.
No. Wait. No, this is a mistake. I'm not gay.
Oh, really? And I'm Tony Danza.
Honestly, I swear it. I'm not.
Well, then tell me. Who was in the Broadway cast of The Pajama Game?
Janice Page, John Raitt, Eddie Floyd Jr. I assume you knew the original cast because there was a revival in 1973 that starred Hal Linden and Barbara McNair. I am gay!
I rest my case.
Wait, I can prove to you that I am not gay. Kiss me.
Oh! This is just sad.
Dad.
You shut
He's like,
up,
not again.
Will you shut up, bitch?
Let me kiss you. Remember the champagne? Corpuscles.
The corpuscles.
Yeah. All right, Elliot.
Before on the balcony.
I forgot.
Very romantic scene.
I forgot, like, how descriptive that scene was as I was rewatching it with
hot,
E&S.
Right?
No, like, I'm like, oh shit.
It's too many big words. It's like.
Yep.
I'm gay.
Like, the first word out of his mouth is penis and clitoris. Like, I'm sorry. I'm like, you don't want to just, like, kiss me on the cheek first, kiss me, nibble on the neck. No, you're just going to say insert penis there. It's not.
No,
start off with the skin is the most, you're soft, supple, beautiful, soft skin. That's where you lead with, not with penis.
Right out
and clitoris.
That was
very bold. It was right out the gate. But again, he had that confidence of a gay.
But honestly, like that whole scene, I had forgot how dramatic that scene was on the balcony with him.
Yeah.
And her.
And oh. I was like, oh,
ready to melt into a puddle.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was gone. I was like, I think I remember like, oh yeah, fuck, he's gay. But I was like, What? My skin? Yep. Every little what? Yep.
You're like, I don't understand the big words, oh but you God. Sound so nice.
Just came to the bedroom already.
Like, if he was that much of a stallion, he would have banged her on the
have
balcony.
Have your way with me. Oh, such a tease. Such a tease. Like, oh my gosh, Mary.
No, it definitely, though, like, again, because we watched this with ENS, and I was sitting there going, ah, shit.
Yeah.
No, they didn't.
What's a clitoris?
No. Thank God, no. I'm just like, we're just going to
breeze right over that word right there.
We're just going to not act like that happened. Oh, yeah, no. Well, he's gay. All right, focus on that.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God.
Those words. Nope.
Oh. And that was when he was done. He's like, I'm not making any more wishes. You just keep fucking with me.
Yeah.
So, like, you ruined them anyways. Yeah. I'm over it.
the gay was the last straw for him. He was like, I just can't compete with you. It. There's nothing you're going to do.
Clearly,
you're just gonna ruin
we are fucking this
I'm
up.
Giving up on Allison. Yeah. I'm just not, like, it's done.
This is not what we're here for. Yeah. So on a deleted version or deleted scene, which you can only access through a DVD and or YouTube, which is where I found it, is the version of him being a rock and roll.
A rock star?
Rock star. So leading up, it happens right after the whole gay thing. Mm-hmm. And they're on the bed.
I'm gonna be as manly as I can. Make me a rock star.
The devil. But honestly, like, that whole interaction in the bedroom with Elliot and the devil, it wasn't really the same level of chemistry as it had been before. The script was kind of weak.
Okay.
I felt. And I'm kind of actually glad that they clipped it.
All right.
It would have been nice to kind of have that rock and roll hard version, because everything else, it seemed kind of like on the surface, like.
So with the seven wishes, would that have been the sixth wish? And instead they were like, clip it. We're going to make the Big Mac and Coke one of the wishes.
Maybe.
Or would they have taken one of the other ones out?
Yeah,
I wonder if they saw it and they were like, you know what? This is pretty weak. Let's just make it fun and say the Big Mac and Coke.
I feel like the president one was probably...
The president one was fun.
But the president one didn't last very long.
Yeah, it was super short.
I mean, the movie's only an hour and a half. So.
I did not even get a clip for that one because it was so... Like, you're the president. Oh, fuck.
You're Lincoln.
Yeah. You're at the play where I die.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. He literally goes, saw who he was and went.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As soon as they sit down, he's like, okay, where's the pager? Because I know I'm busting out of this one immediately.
So that was, it was definitely
I do
not...
like
that.
He's like, are we at a play?
Well, plus she's like, he's like, I want to be president. And she's like, that's the most selfless. No, it's not. 99.9% of the politicians in the universe are not selfless. Mm-hmm. They are the most selfish, power hungry pricks. Mm-hmm. So saying I want to be president.
For selfless reasons. Yeah.
No, it's not. You I mean, know. There are very few, and they are far between, and I appreciate the ones that are and that actually do want to help their fellow man. But it is not like, I want to be president. Like, most of the people who say I want to be president, you need them to have a psych exam and then put them in jail immediately.
I felt like leading into that wish, I definitely thought he was going to choose something different, not just being the president. I was like, he wants to be... helping people.
A philanthropist.
He wants to go out and work
president?
For the
donating
Peace Corps.
Money.
Like, he wants to go out and like
what
help
Bill
with
Gates
this.
Really should be doing with his money. But no, I want to be
no
president.
No. So that was a short clip. I mean, he's like, he looks at the guy.
I think that whole wish lasted probably three and a half minutes.
John Wilkes Booth, is that who shot? Abraham Lincoln. Yeah, so he looks at the John Wilkes Booth and is like, can you hold on for a minute while he does his pager?
Like, okay, go ahead.
Okay, go ahead. Do your thing. So then he comes back. So then he talks to the devil and is like, I've got, two more wishes? And she's like, oh, no, you've got one. Yeah. Because the first one was the Big Mac and Coke, and he's like, he's kind of rebuking it. He's like, no.
Yeah.
That wasn't a wish.
You took me by Subway to get a Big Mac at a McDonald's, and then I had to pay for it. How is that even a wish?
Because, and then she gets him on the technicality because she's Satan. And she's
I did get it for you.
You said I wish.
Yeah.
And then I facilitated it.
Yeah. So, and I love how, thank you. I love how it offended she gets when he implies that she's fair.
Fair?
I don't think I've ever been this insulted in my life. Oh my gosh. Being accused of being fair.
So how is it that he ended up in jail?
Well, because he throws a fucking hissy fit.
Yes.
And then where were they when that happened? Because it was in public and the police ended up coming and getting him.
Office.
They were,
Office of what?
He was yelling at his computer.
Yes.
He was yelling at his computer.
Basically, I think he got fired.
And that's when she was arguing with,
Yeah, she was arguing with him on the computer.
And then he storms out.
And then
out.
He got dragged out and then arrested. Mm-hmm. And then he's like, no, but the cop said this, you know, yada, yada, yada. Or the devil said this. They're like, okay, well, we're just going to lock you up immediately.
Yeah.
And then it's her dragging him in there. And she's like, just get it over with. I love that she turns into bad cop.
I'll butt your ass. You don't even know.
Yeah.
One more word out of you, sicko.
Oh, no. It's because he goes to the church.
That's right. He goes to the church
to ask to talk to God.
And the priest.
And the priest calls the cops to have him.
And the priest is like, oh, you can talk to me. And like, because the priest is Bill Murray's brother, that's Bill Murray's brother.
What?
And he tends to be in Harold Ramis movies. He was in Groundhog's Day.
Huh.
So, you know, he's one of those actors that has worked with the director in a couple movies. Mm-hmm. But yes, so that's Bill Murray's brother, and he's the one that had the police escort him. That's right.
That's right. Okay, yeah. So then he ends up in jail, which we have a little... So, yeah, so she's like, okay, you need to think about this.
I'll be back when you're ready to talk to me.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. Like, it wasn't lying when I said I liked you, having a friend like me, all the things.
Yeah, since you're going to hell anyway.
Just wish your way out of here. Yeah. So then he meets a little friend in jail.
He's a devil, that one.
What?
Which I do love that he goes to the church to try and get an interaction with God, and then he ends up with an interaction with God.
Yes. This movie and the way that they've done this, I really appreciate.
Yeah.
It is a really cool version of those beliefs.
Yeah.
That's a long time. Must have did some really bad shit.
Yeah, I like it that it's not your soul to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
It belongs to God.
Yeah.
Hope you got something good for it.
Matter of fact, I got nothing for it.
Well, that's a really bad deal if you ask me.
Well, I'm not asking you.
Doesn't really matter, though. Can't sell your soul anyway.
Oh, really? Why do you say that?
But it doesn't really belong to you in the first place. No way, no how.
So who does it belong to?
Belongs to God, that universal spirit that animates and binds all things in existence. Devil gonna try to confuse you, but that's a gig. But in the end, you're gonna see clear to who and what you are and what you're here to do. Now, you're gonna make some mistakes along the way, everybody does. But if you just open up your heart and open up your mind, you get it.
Who are you?
Just a friend, brother.
He was great.
He was so good.
For a small role as he had, he was really great.
It was very impactful.
Yeah.
And again, like, I loved it as we're watching. And the first thing when we're watching that scene was he looks at me and she goes, is he an angel? And I was like, yeah.
Better.
Like, he's better, but yes. Like it was just very like I appreciate how very clear cut this movie, you know, makes, you know, sin and good versus evil and all of those things, because, you know, you have to prepare your kids because the world has a lot of evil in it. Mm-hmm. And so, like, you know, you do your best. You want to raise them with strong values. And I think that this is such a great depiction of how greed, how all these superficial things, they don't work out.
Right.
Yeah.
And they aren't what you're supposed to be doing, you know, or what you're supposed to be living for and emulating. Mm-hmm. And I think I really like these types of movies.
Yeah.
And I think that the way that they did this interaction, especially where he's down on his lowest low, mm-hmm. and there's God basically to be like, hey,
yeah,
you're not alone in this.
Yeah.
Like, it's going to be okay.
And the actor they use, I know you talked about this a little earlier, but like, I love his smile. Like, his smile, it just melts you. Like,
yeah, it's heartwarming.
Beautiful. Yeah. Yeah. They chose a great
character. They cast that really well.
Yes. Yes. And then I do love how later in the movie you see them playing chess. Him and the devil playing chess. And I just thought that's funny.
That's the world, right?
Yeah.
Him and the devil are playing chess in the world.
Yeah. It's great.
Yeah.
It's great. Because that's actually, there's several depictions of God and Satan playing chess, mm-hmm. done by various artists, because it's a pretty well-known theme. So I thought it was kind of cool to see it in like a film version. Mm-hmm. Hadn't seen it like that before.
Yeah.
So I think I really enjoyed it. I thought it was really cool.
How did we end up in the in our office again? We went back to the club.
Because he leaves jail. He gets let out of jail.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And then he goes to the club because night in jail, he contemplates his thing and he's like, okay, well, I'm going to tell her that I don't want any more wishes.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that does not go over well. And then she turns into big golden bikini devil and
big golden bikini. Yes. Yes.
Well, yeah. you have the Satan one and then she's
for like half a second.
I know.
And then she's fucking sexy, King Triton.
Yes.
With a gold bikini.
I mean, honestly, if you had her body, hot. I would wear a bikini all the time.
Well, I was telling Ragnar, I was like, if that's what the devil looked like, people would be going every fucking, like, sign me up. I want to go get poked by the gold bikini devil.
It's hot in hell. You got to wear skimpy clothes.
Yeah. Yep.
You got to.
Oh, yep. My goodness. You guys are messes.
The requirements.
So funny.
Spicy disaster. That would be me.
That's when his last wish is that Allison has a happy life.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And that ultimately breaks the contract.
Yep.
Nobody ever reads the fine print of the 875,000 page document.
Yeah, this huge thing.
Yeah.
It's like a bill going through Congress.
Yeah,
it's where gigantic. It's like, oh, this is about the border, but it's also about giving the money to all the corrupt people.
Yeah, disregard the filibuster.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. But on the title page,
yes,
it says it's about the border.
Two sentences,
even though there's not $0 going to the border.
Oh,
yay. It's just a fancy name.
Oh my goodness. But yeah, that huge freaking contract.
Yes.
I do love again just earlier when he's like, the damned.
Like, what did you think you were gonna be if you're making a deal with it? You're talking about making a deal with the devil and that surprises you.
Yeah, I know
you
the lingo. Getting hooked up on the terminology.
Fucking moron.
Oh, but it was great. He really plays such a goofball in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And then you see him grow and you see him change and you see him mature as he goes through these different life experiences with these dreams.
Yeah.
And you know what? And again, it's really cool because it's to me, like, it's that symbolic, like, you're going through, you're growing as a human, you know, life is changing, all of these things. But like, and again, you generally think you're aspiring to being good. You're not necessarily selling your soul to Satan.
Mm.
But like that growth that happens in this way, yes, it's hilarious and all of the things, but it was really cool how it translated.
Yeah.
It was really cool to see that character develop and that character become so deep by the end of it.
Yeah.
Like to the point that when the friends come up to mock him and hey, Pavilion,
you
and he
funny?
Just looks at him and he's like, nice seeing you, Bob. I was like, yes.
You know what's funny is that whenever I first saw that the first time, I really thought that his friends, I didn't know his friends were making fun of him.
Like, oh, really?
I didn't catch that until I watched it the second time or this recently. That's what that was happening. But I think I actually have a clip of that interaction. Maybe.
Oh, $10. It's a joke. What's he gonna
do? Hey, 10 bucks.
Elliot, Fofelli, so smelly. What's up, dudester? Yeah. What do you say we go down to the club tonight and we pick up some chickettes, huh?
Nice talking to you, Bob.
Yes. That version of Elliot or Brendan was
hot.
Hot. Yes. 100%.
Oh, yeah. Confidence is sexy.
Well, that's more in line with, like, the Rick from The Mummy.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
Like, he's somebody who still kind of heartwarming, but he has, like, this I know what I'm capable of self-confidence that he had developed in having all these ruined wishes.
Mm-hmm.
And that comes with kind of loving oneself over worrying about what other people's opinions are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Which I think is super, super important.
Yeah, and I think it's interesting. I mean, the whole movie, he wouldn't have become the person he was if it wasn't for the devil
doing
testing him.
Yeah,
and
which is funny
making
because
him feel like, you know, what he that a better version of him would have been better, but in real, you know, in the end, it's just him.
Mm-hmm.
You know. It's very interesting because, you know, in life
she was the best thing that ever happened to him.
Yeah I mean, in life we are tested, but we learn from that, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But and we should hopefully
you know,
some people do.
We eventually will learn one way or the other.
Yeah
And the director Harold Ramis was a very spiritual person.
Mm-hmm.
On the very end clip you see the monk sitting at the I guess like everything around the couple of between him and now Nicole, everything is in fast motion except for them and a couple people sitting on some benches.
Mm-hmm.
But the monk was kind of like a nod towards Harold Ramis's,
I didn't even notice the monk.
Idea
of spirituality. Yeah, just a bit monk sitting on a bench.
Yeah.
Oh, I never even noticed him.
And how, you know, just about like life's journey of realizing that in the end, the best version of you is you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right? It's not something that you wish you could be better at this or better at that, but it will grow you into the better person that you would be.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
If that makes any sense. I feel like at this point with all these drinks, I'm just saying words that hopefully will make sense to somebody out there.
I'll just string some words together. Yeah, this one is pretty toasty.
Right,
not gonna lie.
At the end,
my cheeks are numb.
Oh my god!
Which, if my cheeks are numb, then I'm headed towards the. It's my cheeks and my lips.
Once
my cheeks, nose, and lips. Once they start to get a little bit numb, then or tingly, then I'm like, okay, we're having a good time.
Yeah. At the very end,
I can't feel the apples of my cheeks.
You may want to add more apple juice. No, that wasn't even in it. Orange juice. To try and dilute a little bit because it's very strong.
I mean, at this
the
point, there is no reason to dilute that.
You're
that
right.
is a gulp.
You are at a shot.
There you go.
Yep.
Nicely good. Done. There's
Look
no.
Look at you finishing before I got it. Did it.
Sorry.
And that's
Nothing.
The end.
Thanks for joining us. Check out the Coffee Brothers, BAC 10%.
Oh, one thing I thought I would just thought was really kind of interesting. So, you know, John Cleese.
Yes.
He was in
all of the things.
All of the things.
Yeah. Yeah.
The Monty Python.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So apparently he had met up with Harold at a lunch, and they were Harold was like, "Oh, you know, what are we filming today?" And Harold was explaining to him, "Oh, you know, we're filming a Colombian drug lord who speaks Spanish, but he doesn't know he speaks Spanish until he speaks Spanish."
Mm-hmm.
And John just starts busting out like, "Oh, I haven't heard that one before." So this is an interview with Brendan Fraser, and he was like, "I've kind of got the Monty Python stamp of approval for this movie." When John Cleese is like,
"Think that's funny.
That is funny."
Yeah.
And I was like, "Woo, this might actually have something." So
that is cool.
So that was really interesting. Yeah.
That is cool.
A little nod to Monty Python there.
I love me some John Cleese. Absolutely love Monty Python.
Yeah.
I like him as nearly
this
as
bird snake. Is no more. So great. I used to have Flying Circus on CD.
Mm-hmm.
I got it from one of my friends in high school. So they ripped it for me.
Yeah.
And oh my, that's how much of a nerd I was that we were ripping Monty Python skits.
Oh my gosh.
But that's cool. That is a fun tidbit.
Yeah. I wanted to ask which iteration of Wish Elliot, not real Elliot after he's gone through all these experiences, you know.
Yeah.
But what iteration of Wish Elliot do you like the most? Oh, like, would you find yourself being trapped with? Which one would you be okay being trapped with?
Which one
with?
Oh, boy.
Wish Elliot only. So you've got basketball tic tac tic. You've got the big dick suave gay one.
Yeah.
You've got the Abraham Lincoln one.
You've got
the sensitive one with all the freckles and the crying.
Oh, Jesus.
And then you've
got Colombian drug lord.
Colombian drug lord. And yeah.
Oh, that's a tough one.
Oh. Which one does it?
How can you choose?
The greasy Colombian drug lord.
I know what Tammy's going to choose. I know 100% what Tammy's going to choose.
I may surprise you.
Can I guess?
Yeah.
I'm going to go with the Colombian drug lord.
No.
Really?
I'm going to go with suave gay.
Really?
Yes. You would rather be with the suave gay.
He's never going to get an erection for you.
He's pretty to look at.
And he's articulate.
And I can talk to him and we can talk for hours.
And his teeth are straight.
And he's pretty. And there's no he's saying pretty. That we can't cuddle.
Maybe he could do your hair.
Cuddle. We can cuddle.
Oh my
I'm
gosh.
Really okay with cuddling. So yeah, I'm actually going to go with suave gay.
That's funny.
Yikes.
Just because he's pretty to look at.
I
he probably knows how to cook too.
I feel like I can't go with the gay guy because he's not going to do anything for.
I got a shower
You're
head.
You're going to be unrequited be the entire time.
That's what shower heads are for. You'll be right. fine.
There are other ways.
No.
Girl's going to take care of business one way or the other.
No.
I'm curious which
there
one
there are some
picking.
Things a vibrator cannot fix.
Yeah.
Like you need the body attached to the vibrator and that's just not going to work for me.
Emotional connection with another person.
Yeah, that's overrated. I'm dead inside.
Wow. Okay.
And apparently you're dead outside too because you're not getting laid.
I'm very, very numb.
On our next show, we'll talk about... Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I think I would end up... Oh, I would have... I would either go with the drug lord or the sensitive one. I think between those two...
You got to narrow it down. Got to pick one.
I know. I'm going to go with the drug lord.
I would go with the drug lord too. I would 100% go with the greasy ass drug lord. Like, I will wash the grease off of you.
As his
and
wife?
We will be okay.
Yeah, like, I'm
like
not
it's
involved.
A nice house.
Yeah.
Like, we can get out of the drug business, you know, or we can just arm ourselves really well.
Especially when we think it's like, flour or sugar.
Like, he's devoted.
Yeah.
He's very happy to just be alive. Like, yeah. Like I'll take
he
the optimistic
has a good
drug
size
lord.
Penis, too.
I mean, maybe.
It's probably not tiny dick basketball
We're hoping
guy.
Not.
I would assume it'd be normal for him.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think he was...
He's going to take me to Misa Stables. I'll be like, let's go to Misa Stables. Usa Stables. I want to go to Usa Stables. We'll do this.
Get it on in Mrs. Stables. With a new stallion, yeah.
Oh. I stand with my choice.
Yeah. You're going to go.
Yeah.
You're going to go get it on with the gay guy.
I think because, you know, as the wife of a drug lord, I don't know if you're fully invested in his business plans.
No, you're not involved. You're just there to be pretty.
You're his girl that's got all the monies that can just do stuff with.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I can't imagine anybody choosing the basketball player because one,
oh,
he was
gosh,
ugly.
He's just gross.
He was also stupid.
Dumb.
He's just
and
gross.
Stupid.
There's
and there's
no,
nothing to the table.
No, no attracting
well,
features.
Okay, plus, even like as large as he was,
his
he didn't have any
not.
Muscle definition.
No.
He was like just a really tall white
yeah.
boy. There was
it
nothing
was
there. He should have had pecs and yeah. abs, and he didn't. He had a very unathletic body for being 8 feet tall, which was
yeah.
weird.
Yeah. That was weird.
Like,
lanky.
Yeah.
He was very lanky.
Yeah, he was super, like, skinny arms. Mm-hmm. I'm like, what the fuck, dude?
I did feel like they kind of dropped the ball in that rendition because
yeah.
He's not, no.
No, there
and
was nothing good there.
One of his wishes was to be
athletic and strong.
Strong.
And yeah, he I did mean, not, he had, my biceps are bigger.
Yeah.
And they're not that big.
On the... Back on the behind the scenes videos, he actually did have muscle because they were showing the tattoo they had put on his arm and he's
yeah.
like flexing forward.
All the random ass tattoos like a gecko,
right? And the line
a
on the shoulder,
weird line that's
yeah.
like a mountain range.
Yeah,
Plus, like, my tattoos need a story. I can't deal with the random fucking pick them off the wall tattoos.
Yeah.
And your bleach ass fucking white blonde albino hair. Fuck off.
So
he's definitely the worst.
So he did. I mean, he did have, he showed like he had muscle in in the behind the scenes videos. But when you see him actually in the movie itself,
like even the way he's standing, yeah.
He's weird looking.
It was so, I don't know if it was the way they were trying to portray him to be that tall against her. Cause she looked like a fucking midget next to him.
Did they actually say he was like 8 feet tall in that one?
It's 7'6".
Yeah.
Is that what they said?
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah. Fuck. But he looked way taller than 7'6".
Yeah.
So it was, it was really funny.
It was like a comedic 7'6".
It was a really comedic 7'6".
Cause he came out and like, he didn't have, like he had a, like
to duck under the thing. He's as tall as the basketball hoop.
And he's literally like, they're handing him like autographs on like the top of
there's no reason for him to jump to make the dunk because he could just stand on his toes and do it like it was ridiculous yeah it was that whole character was really ridiculous but
I'd say that was my least favorite.
I would agree with the Colombian drug lord.
Mm-hmm. And
I don't like dolphin tuna guy.
Oh no. I mean, if I had to take a vision that I'd bang, I'd go drug lord if I was going to go the bang route. But I'm really like, okay,
we're
going to
just only do it in the shower where you can be less greasy.
I we'll think make that happen. They had actually cut
we'll
some
install
scenes.
A jacuzzi with all of your drug cocaine's money.
They had actually cut some scenes from his sensitive scene.
Because
it just got too much.
Yeah.
And I can totally get that.
It was already too much.
It was,
right?
It was right there on the cusp of being way too much.
Yeah.
And thankfully,
which
they
is what she dealt with for 3 weeks, was which I she's like, I really can't tell
imagine?
You I'm breaking up with you.
No. Yeah. I'd be done with that in like under 5 minutes.
I mean, someone who's like, who can share, but that's not what you want in a partner.
No.
I want a man.
Yes. Amen.
Yeah.
I want someone who.
Which is why I think the sensitive thing was totally made up by the devil, because I don't.
I think all.
You want somebody to be emotionally available, but not.
Yeah.
Emotionally sensitive to where, like, I'm a very sarcastic person. I do not want to hurt your feelings. Like, I don't ever want to hurt anybody's feelings. I say I don't have a filter. Mm-hmm. I'm sure anybody who listens to the show realizes this.
Please don't be offended.
No. I mean, if you are, I don't care.
Nobody cares.
It's grow bigger feelings.
Bigger feelings?
Yeah. Thicker skin. It's the world is a big, bad place and you shouldn't be that sensitive. It's one of those things to where like what I say has no mean feelings behind it, but what I say doesn't have a lot of thought behind it, honestly, because my brain goes to my mouth before anything else can stop it. And if something pops in my head, you will hear some stuff. You never know what's coming out of my mouth. Interesting. So yeah, I don't need somebody that I'm going to hurt their feelings on accident all the time when there's no evil intention behind me. And I don't want somebody who's going to cry more than I am.
No.
I was going to ask you guys about if you had 7 wishes, the devil came up to you, you had 7 wishes to, I don't know, to woo the person that of your dreams. But I honestly thought like after watching, I don't know any of us who would, I feel like after watching this movie, you'd be super detailed exactly of what you wanted.
Yeah.
Or would you just be like, you know what? I'm good. I'll work it out on my own. I don't need you to intervene in my life.
Yeah.
Well, I'd be taking the latter. I'd be like, I don't need to be dancing with the devil. I could.
Well, it was funny because when we were watching the movie, Ragnar was like, so would you sell your soul for the wishes? And I'm going, no. No, I don't think I would, because
I think I'd work it out on my own.
Well, the thing is like, you don't know what's on the other side of that caveat. And if I don't have every detail of that, like if I'm not taking the time to read that fucking contract, I am not going to sign on the dotted line. I really want to know what I'm getting into. And I don't want to condemn myself for a momentary gratification.
Yeah.
Now, if I had 7 wishes, I'm sure there's 7 wishes I could come up with.
Yeah,
but not with the caveat that it's going to condemn me to hell.
Yeah,
like then I'm going to be like, I'm just going to live the way I'm living because I'm honestly a very happy person.
Yeah,
so I'm okay.
No, I'm same for me. Like honestly, because for me, it's just like your end game is to screw me over. So yeah. I'm not going to win at the end of this.
No trust there
at all. No trust to start.
Especially when the wishes go as fast as they do, when you realize the wishes are every 3 hours. Like, you don't even get a full fucking day.
Somebody's trying to murder you.
Yeah.
It's not working out.
Yeah. I'm like, I'm okay. I really don't need this to, I would like a longer life than that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So do you guys want to go into ratings?
Yeah,
I think we can.
What are we doing?
I think
pitchforks.
Oh.
Contracts.
What are we? Wishes.
Wishes.
Wishes. All right. Five wishes. All right.
Yeah. So out of five wishes, all right. Sammy, what do you got?
All right. So out of five wishes, I am going to give this 3.5 wishes.
Okay.
I really enjoy it. Is it Brendan Fraser's best? No, it's not.
The Mummy is.
The Mummy by far is amazing.
Yeah.
And I like him in some other ones. Like I like him in Blast from the Past.
Yeah.
He's really good in that one.
Yeah.
He's got a couple. I mean, for dramatic, I have to go with The Whale. I mean, The Whale is amazing.
And I cannot wait to see that.
We're eventually going to be doing that as the third installment for this trifecta, so, and I'm really excited about it.
Listen in to hear our
future Whale episode.
Yes.
And this one, it is a fun movie. It is quirky and goofy and it's silly and it's quotable and it's just 90 minutes of just fun.
Mm-hmm.
I would recommend it if you've got, you know, if you haven't seen it and if you're in a bad mood, put it on. It'll make you laugh. Like no matter how many times you see it, you're going to laugh because it's funny.
Yeah.
It's a funny movie. And it is sweet because you see after all of the growth with Elliot, you see him, he ends up with the girl of his dreams. It's not technically her, you know.
But he didn't know Allison before. So Nikki is just what she looks like.
Exactly. It's that physical.
But the personality that
exactly
matches up. Yeah.
Exactly. And I think that's kind of cool because mm-hmm. he ends up being selfless and then he ends up being rewarded.
Yeah.
Which is really, really cool. And, you know, and anyways, it's a sweet movie. It's a funny movie. Elizabeth Hurley does an amazing job in it.
Yes.
Her and Brendan's chemistry on screen is great. And yeah, I really enjoyed it. So yeah, 3.5. 3.5 wishes.
I love it.
Awesome. For me, I would give it 3 wishes. It's one of those to where I don't know how often I could sit and watch it, but if I watch it, I'm going to enjoy it. There's a lot of fun. It's super silly. I love Elizabeth Hurley is the best thing in the movie. She's fantastic. She makes a great devil and temptress, and she's just super, super fun in general. I enjoy it it's been years since I've seen this movie, but mm-hmm. it was like no problem at all. I was looking forward to sitting and watching it. And it's fun. And you just see so many different you see the same actors just portraying so many different people. It's like they get to be in like 7 different movies themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, it's not like all of the people who are involved had just the best time because they weren't roped into this one little character.
Yeah.
They all got to be all of these different characters have this freeing fun. And you can really see it in the end product. It's just one of those stupid, fun little movies. Doesn't take a lot of time out of your day. Definitely recommend because it's got a nice little twist in it that makes it heartfelt, but it's also just like a silly, stupid little movie.
Yeah.
I enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice. I think I will give it 3.5 wishes as well.
Hey.
You know, it's not the best movie you've ever seen, but I love the fact that it, you know, after seeing it, it's very light.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not a very heavy emotional movie. It's very light on the comedy, on the itty bitty romance. I could definitely probably show this to my kids and not feel like worried that they're going to take something.
Just fast
out
forward
of
through the court puzzles part.
They probably wouldn't even pay attention to me. But you're right. You're right.
There's so many big words. They're going to be like, I don't know what they're saying.
And they may not understand the whole gay part either. They're like, what's gay? And I'm like, okay, I understand you're 6 and 8. I'll explain this to you. I really just enjoy watching this. Mm-hmm. And the little comedy bits that are in it.
It has a lot of subtlety in the movie, which is fun.
Yeah, and I like that. I like that little subtle comedy that or the little things that you kind of have to look for to see. I don't know if that makes a whole lot of sense, but yeah. So I'll give it 3.5 wishes.
Nice, excellent.
Really enjoy that.
It's so fun to have you back on the show.
I'm so excited to be back.
It's been such a long time, but it's so good to have you.
I want to apologize. Fun. I want to apologize to all of the listeners out there. I haven't been around lately. You know, kids' schedules and work schedules have
life
been
is busy.
Bananas. So hopefully I will be able to creep back in a little bit more.
Yay!
Yes. So fun.
It was.
Because we do have the whale.
The whale.
To follow up with this.
Yes.
Which is going to be totally seen it. No, I've never seen
it. I've not seen it either.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you're hosting it and you've not seen it. And exactly. I've never seen it because once you said you wanted to do it, I was like, well, I'm just going to avoid it until.
Because I feel like it's such, I mean, with all of Brendan Fraser's characters, I really tried to grab
very different.
Yeah.
Oh,
personalities.
So the whale is going to be a completely different viewing. It's really good.
So this one, you know, this Bedazzled was very light, very heavy on the comedy, and had left you with a good feeling inside. Mm-hmm. You know, the Mummy is going to be action, comedy, romance,
and all of the tropes,
all the things. Yeah. All the, you know, the woo, yeah, woo ha, hee hee ha.
Yeah.
Feeling.
Yes.
You finish The Mummy and you want to go watch the sequel. That's what it is. Yes.
And then, so The Whale, you know, I haven't seen it, but I have heard it's a very heavy on the drama and it really opens your eyes to a lot of things. And is kind of, in the end, it's kind of sad, but it's, I think it's a definitely different direction than what you usually see Brendan Fraser come in as.
Mm-hmm.
And he hadn't done quite that many
dramatic
movies
before
this one. I think he had taken a break for a while just because, you know, all of Hollywood was really getting to him. It was a lot. I mean, when you have a director in The Mummy that tells you that your hanging was just a meh, you know, after a while, after realizing that.
Well, when you almost die during filming and the guy is like, he's fine.
No
care. Get up and walk it off.
No, it's just forgiven.
It was his fault. It's fine when it was his direction that made him do it. Like, it's, that director is a piece of work right there.
For him to have the strength to come back in such a deeply emotional movie, it'll be very interesting to watch. And I look forward to that. And I hope you guys look forward to listening to about it.
Yes. Be good.
Yeah. All right, so we do ratings? We did ratings.
We already did. We're done.
We're done.
This is it.
Yes.
Join us on Friday for the FMK where we talk about demons, devils, and angels.
Yes.
Yes.
Sweet. And you can find us on the Instagram at Barrel Age Chicks.
Yeah.
Check out Coffee Brothers. Yes, they are coffee. Awesome.
BAC10 for some 10% off action.
That's right. Off of your order.
BAC10.
Start BAC your day 10. The awesome cool. day. Awesome way with Coffee Brothers.
I mean, how else are you starting?
I mean...
But awesome, right?
Don't be depressed.
Let's start awesome.
That'd be definitely a good thing.
We'll start off awesome, then maybe it'll trickle down to the rest of the day. And by the time we go to bed, we'll be fine.
Yeah.
There you go.
And then do it again.
And then restart the next day. Yeah.
All right. Thanks for joining us. And we's out.
Yeah. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Hi, this is Snow. Thanks for listening to our podcast, Barrel Age Chicks. It's 2023 and the chicks are here. We are so excited to share our future episodes of Barrel Age Chicks, FMK, and Slasher Gal Pals. We hope you are enjoying our shenanigans as much as we do. Give us a follow on Instagram at Barrel Age Chicks. If you'd like the gals to do a fan request, contact us on Instagram and we will give you a personal shout out on the show. Our podcast is available on Anchor, Spotify, Apple, Google, iHeartRadio, and GoodPods. Swag available through the link on Instagram. Please check it out and thank you for your support. Special thanks to Carl Casey at White Bat Audio for his kick-ass music. He is amazing. Also, please grab a listen to the guys at Barrel Age Flicks Podcast. If you like booze, hilarity, and movies, check them out. Also, check out our network and other amazing podcasts at deluxeeditionnetwork.com. Bye till next time, and thanks for listening to our show. The party's leaving!